So I'm on the streets of Agripada, and I'm going to be talking to someone who's given us some really interesting insights into the underworld with his books like Dongi to Dubai and Mafia Queens of Mumbai, and actually many others. And I'm going to be in conversation with, of course, Mr. Hussain Zaidi. Thank you, sir.
Hi.
And welcome to the Quint. And I think we couldn't have found a better place to talk about
This is
your
South
work.
Mumbai, and actually Mumbai Muslim Mafia had a major stronghold in this area. Hmm. So it's about Dongri, Nagpada, Agripada, Bombay Central. Those are the places where Dawood and his gang ruled the roost.
Your new book is actually about Dawood Ibrahim's mentor Khalid, right?
Khalid lived in a place near Bombay Central, just nearby.
So it's about 2 minutes walking distance from this place.
You've of course written about Dawood, and many people have written about him.
Yeah.
How is it that someone so sort of integral to his life has not been written about?
It's all about getting interested in a profile or in a person. At the time when I was writing Black Friday in the year 1998, I was trying to look for research material on Dawood Ibrahim. Now, Dawood had been involved in the underworld since 1974, but no book was written on him until then. We all, as a writer and journalist, we choose our topics for investigation or the story that we need to cover. Mm-hmm. Similarly, Khalid Khan was a mystery. Mm-hmm. He had retired from underworld in the year 1992. And he had gone away to Dubai, and since then he was not accessible to anyone.
Right.
Even I did not know about it. I was under the impression that maybe Khalid Pehlwan has died and kind of forgotten in the annals of Mumbai Mafia history. But when I heard about him being alive and his people threatening Sanjay Gupta, the famous film director, it was then that I realized that he's still alive and maybe I can make an attempt to talk to him and maybe his story can be told.
I think you mentioned somewhere in 2015 that you read about this.
Actually it was soon after shootout at Wadala. Mm-hmm. So I went to Dubai several times. Mm-hmm. My first meeting with Khalid was not a pleasant one. He did not like it because I carried a laptop and with me, because I was a journalist, I was trying to write as and when I could. So he saw the laptop and he did not like it.
Huh.
He thought maybe I want to do some mischief.
Huh.
See, there was no trust factor between us. It was my first meeting. But from second, third meetings, he kind of warmed up and he became very friendly.
But what intrigued you about this story particularly? I mean, you've narrated a few incidents in the book about how he kind of saved Dawood's life in this one particular occasion. And there are these really like definitive moments that the two of them shared. What was it that
for me, Khalid Pehlwan is a study in paradox.
Hmm.
See, you know that Dawood's main rivals were Pathans, Amir Zad and Alamzain. Dawood himself is a Konkani Muslim. Most of the Pathans should be opposed to him. Hmm. However, Khalid himself, who is a true blue Pathan, he decided to oppose his own clan of Pathans and sided with Dawood, who was Pathan's rival. Khalid risked his life several times to save Dawood's life when he was attacked by his Pathan enemies. Thing is that Khalid, despite coming from a very Muslim dominant locality and coming from a communal area of Madhya Pradesh, you know, Madhya Pradesh is the most communal state in this country.
Right.
So even the first wrestling bout that he had was made into a communal match between him and the Hindu wrestler Ram Dayal Pehlwan at that time. Khalid still wanted to hire Hindu gang members in Dawood's gang. And when he was questioned, he said ke Dawood yaad rakhna ke Musalman tumko dhoka de sakte hain lekin Hindu gang wale dhoka nahi denge. I mean, these are so many very curious things which Khalid has in his personality.
Right.
And I thought that this man should be told and people should know about him.
So you've of course been a crime reporter for a long time, like you said, for about 24 years before you actually started writing books. Now the perception is that this is something that's very exciting and very thrilling and crime journalists are living their life on the edge. Is it really that thrilling, and what has been possibly the most fascinating experience for you in that time?
See, if you are referring to some of the movies that you have seen and if you feel that because of those movies it would
do this
thrilling thing, then it is not. I mean, imagine you're dealing with cops and you're dealing with criminals and both of them don't trust and both of them cannot be trusted.
Right.
So how do you convince them to give you stories? How do you make cops to, you know, confide in you, and how do you make criminals, you know, into opening up? I think it's quite difficult, you know. For me, the most interesting encounter was with one guy, Hussain Sheikh Ustra. Ustra is in the blade. When he was a young boy, he was a pickpocket. So he got attacked by his enemies in a bar. He had nothing else to defend himself but a small razor. So he attacked someone with that razor. And when this guy was taken to the hospital, the doctor who was operating on him for stitches and all, he was surprised because he said that the attack seemed to be you know, inflicted on him like with a clinical precision.
Right.
Which seemed like that the man was quite an expert in using that blade. Hmm. And that's how Hussain Sheikh became Hussain Ustara.
Hmm.
So he had narrated a very, very interesting story of this woman called Sapna Didi.
Right, right, right.
So that Sapna
and the
Didi
film was going to be made on
Vishal Bhardwaj is making a movie on it. So it was a fantastic story of this housewife whose husband was reportedly killed by Dawood Ibrahim in an encounter outside Mumbai airport through one of the cops in the Mumbai police.
Hmm.
So how this housewife transformed into an underworld operative herself, and how Sapna Didi ensured that she will train herself in all kinds of weaponry, all kinds of street fight, to ensure that she becomes fit enough to kill Dawood Ibrahim. So that's the story which I have mentioned in my book, Mafia Queen. As that is one memorable encounter for me.
But have these experiences never been like really chilling for you? Like it's just not, or is this something you really want to do and hence?
See, the problem is that if I have some kind of agenda for myself,
right,
then there will be problem. Scared. But I don't take sides. For me, criminals are not friends. I mean, I have spoken to Arun Gavli, Chota Rajan, and Ashwin Naik, everyone. But since I don't take sides, nobody distrusts me or nobody has any kind of skepticism about me.
What do you think of like Bollywood's depiction of gangster films? I mean, what is...
They like to glorify gangsters. They cast a star in a stellar role.
Huh.
So they can't show that particular star in a bad light.
Hmm.
They have to be sympathetic or they have to show something heroic about it.
Hmm.
But
if you're like a Rai, so like, you know, one of these.
I will not name movies because most of these guys are my friends. But actually, if you see gangsters, I don't think that they are brave people. Just because they have a weapon in hand, that doesn't make them brave or heroic.
Hmm.
Most of them are desperate. Just take the gun away and they will not have any heroism left
in
them.
Right, right. But tell me a little bit about Dawood. I mean, one hears that he's not as well right now and he's suffering.
I don't know what the source of this information. See, this is the kind of story which keep coming up. I mean, that is a case that guy would have gone to some hospital in London or US for treatment. These are unconfirmed stories which keep happening.
But has his empire shrunk now? Is it still intact? What?
I mean, the level of activity has decreased. But now he is lying low, and Chota Shakil has also not been so active.
So I think when you give me your research, I'm sure you're pretty like acquainted with this space, like I said earlier.
So you have to, because this is my jurisdiction, my bailiwick, where I need to understand this area, the people, the sources, how it operates, who are the people who can reveal some inside stuff to me.
So, of course, this, like I mentioned, is Agripada, but what were the areas here that, say, Dawood frequented?
Nagpada,
which is a little...
Nobody. It's here, close by.
Hmm. But in this area, not.
Since you wanted to talk to me in the area where Khalid Pehlwan lived,
right.
So I thought that Bombay Central ke paas mein, this is the closest place, where at least we can stand and talk. Otherwise, Dongri is very congested. And then you have tea here.
Of course. But is Dawood still living in Karachi or like?
Boss, see, we all, the agencies know where Dawood is.
Right.
Matlab, they even know the street, the house, place, everything. Matlab, there was an intelligence guy who was telling me that Dawood's son Moin has become very religious and he has got a huge beard. Ab aapko itna sab bhi pata hai. Aapko pata hai Dawood kahan reh raha. You don't know, you even know what his son is doing. They know ke Dawood ki beti jo hai, where they study, which college in London. भाई तो फिर आपको जब पता है तो why don't you get Dawood back?
Right.
But well, I realize that they don't want to get Dawood back. There's a lack of political will to get him back.
Has there been some sort of settlement with the government, with the Indian government?
No, there's no settlement. See, Dawood की problem ये है कि if he comes to Mumbai or India, बहुत से जो नेता हैं, बहुत से जो politicians हैं, who are on his payroll. They will open up. They will start talking about or Dawood ka jo sara connections hai, wo sab in netaon ke saath open hone lagega. It's convenient for them that Dawood should not come back.
Of course, the nexus between Bollywood and underworld is something that we've all sort of known about, and a lot has been said about it.
Huh.
But I read somewhere where you said that now the funding, because of the whole corporate structure of Bollywood and the way films are made, is of course much lesser and almost negligible.
Yeah.
But you said there are certain, like, say, smaller, like B films that are still sort of dependent on.
Because see, filmmaking is a big money business. Everyone doesn't have it. Even corporates don't want to give it so easily.
Hmm.
But Dawood is sitting on a huge stash of money and his friends like to borrow from him or also would like to make a partner with him in joint venture.
Right. So there's still some amount of financing.
It's a strategic alliance, I would say.
Hmm.
But when Dawood will invest money, he won't even seek that kind of accounting from him. We all know about what happened with Chota Shakil and Nazim Rizvi in Chori Chori Chupke Chupke. So that was one venture which came out. But there were so many other business projects and film and Bollywood which you don't know.
But coming back to the book, I mean, what do you think this book is going to give readers that they probably don't know?
See, it's a different take on Dawood's life. We don't know that who trained him. Khalid Melwan, as I said, is an economics graduate from Sophia College in Saifia College in Bhopal. Now, who would have heard of a graduate gangster in 1968? And then the man, apart from being graduate, comes from a family of wrestlers. So what I'm trying to say is that he has not become gangster out of circumstance or compulsion, as people would like to project. What happened was that he defeated a particular wrestler in Delhi, where he was spotted by Bashu Dada, who at the time was the reigning don in Mumbai. Bashu Dada brought him to Mumbai, and then through a series of events which I've mentioned in the book, Khalid and Dawood met. They both struck a friendship, and then Khalid started training Dawood. He developed a liking for this boy of 14-year-old, and they became friends. You will see that the man still remained untouched by the cunning, Machiavellian, violent ways of Mumbai underworld. Khalid Pehlwan, despite all his acumen and smartness, made one small mistake. He got deceived by one of his confidants, and he realized that now he should not be into this underworld anymore. He should quit. So my thing is that which gangster, after coming into underworld, ever thinks of quitting it? Which
right.
He did.
It's you're sucked into it. There's no way out, right? Well, all the very best for the book, and we're looking forward to reading it. And thank you for being on the Quint and doing this,
thank
showing
you,
us around Agripada and having chai with
thank
us.
Thank you.